Youth from Ankole sub-region who subscribe to the Patriotic League of Uganda have requested President Yoweri Museveni to retire General Muhoozi Kainerugaba so that he can run in the 2026 presidential elections. General Kainerugaba is currently the Chief of Defense Forces of UPDF and Senior Presidential Advisor on Special Operations. The youth said he's the only candidate who can maintain the stability of Uganda after Museveni in 2026.
So we request President Museveni that since we already have our corruption fighter, General Muhoozi Kainerugaba, we have already seen that he can fight corruption. He is the real anti-corruption crusader. Not even Museveni or opposition can finish the corruption here in Uganda.
They made the remarks today while addressing the media at a new Pearl Hotel in Barra City. A statement that was read by Bruce Ainomgisha said the corrupt people have kept the state in captivity and that General Kainerugaba is the only suitable candidate to hold the mantle after Museveni.
We, as part of the PRU Youth League, believe that the great leadership of the great father of the nation and Africa at large, President Museveni's image is going to be tainted if he does not agree.
Hope Kankunda, a member of the Youth League, said there is need for continuity which can be granted with General Kainerugaba taking over. Bunyole East Member of Parliament in Butaleja District, Yusuf Mutembuli, has been compared to Nelson Mandela by his supporters and sympathizers. Mutembuli made the revelation while addressing journalists and a section of his electorate in Butaleja Town Council. He was in the campaign of Man Member of Parliament for Butaleja District, Florence Andiru Nibanda.
For my people of Butaleja, I want to assure you that for the time that I'm on bail, I'm going to execute my duties. I'm going to do whatever is supposed to be done.
Amid jubilation, Mutembuli's supporters swept through Butaleja town, chanting songs of praise and encouragement to the embattled legislator amid corruption charges that he's faced with. Mutembuli declined to comment in detail about the corruption charges that he's battling, saying that the truth shall be known after the court rules on the matter.
At the conclusion of this case, the details will be given. Right now, we cannot discuss the details.
Mutembuli narrated his prison ordeal, advising his supporters to avoid prison detention as much as possible. He described how he lost 10 kgs in 2 months while in jail. The legislator further did not hesitate to comment on the fact that his supporters compared him to Nelson Mandela because of his imprisonment as a leader.
As soon as I reached the bridge, people were calling me Mandela. I asked myself how. They said Mandela was in prison and you have also been in prison. Therefore, you qualify to be Mandela.
Mutembuli, 43, is battling graft charges along with Paula Kamba, the Busiki Constituency Member of Parliament, and Susan Namuju, the Woman Member of Parliament for Rengo District. The prosecution alleges that the trial on May 13, 2024, at Hotel Africana in Kampala, solicited from Mariam Wangadia, the chairperson of the Human Rights Commission, an undue advantage of 20% of the anticipated enhanced budget of the Uganda Human Rights Commission for the financial year 2024-2025, a charge they all deny. A military court in the Democratic Republic of Congo on Thursday handed death sentences to all 26 defendants accused of belonging to the M23 rebel group after a high-profile trial. The defendants, 21 of whom are on the run, were found guilty of war crimes, participation in an insurrection, and treason by the court in the capital, Kinshasa. The Tutsi-led M23, backed by Rwanda, has seized huge swathes of territory in eastern DRC since late 2021. It is among dozens of rebel groups active in the DRC's restive east, many the legacy of a regional conflict that erupted in the 1990s after the fall of longtime dictator Mobutu Seseko. In March, the Congolese government defied criticism from human rights organizations and lifted a moratorium on the death penalty that had been in place since 2003, aiming to target military personnel accused of treason. The prosecutor in the trial, which began on July 24th, had called for death sentences against 25 of the defendants and the 20-year jail term against the other defendant. Defense lawyers for the 5 accused who were present in court pleaded for their acquittal. The most prominent of the defendants was Cornel Nanga, among those on the run, and a former president of the Congolese Electoral Commission. Other major M23 figures on trial include its president, Bertrand Bisima, military chief, Sultani Makenga, spokesperson, Willy Ngoma, and Lawrence Kanyuka.